All right, everybody, welcome to the Studying Brew episode 890 on this beautiful Tuesday evening. It is Test Taking Techniques Tuesday. It is technique night. That means that we are going to show you how to get those right answers without knowing a dang thing.
Yep.
That's a beautiful thing, because let me tell you, there's moments where you feel like you don't know a dang thing. Even if you've been studying, you're like, man, I feel like I don't even know what this is saying to me right now.
Like, I don't know a dang thing.
I feel like I don't even know what language this is in. I see the words. I kind of know the words, but it's not clicking anything. It happens to the best of us. It happened to Brandy. It happened to anybody, right? And the other thing about the techniques is not only that, but it's helpful when you're running out of time on the exam. Maybe you had a breakdown in the middle of the exam, right? You had one of those moments where you just had to call upon a higher power. You know what I mean? And then you just like, oh man, where'd the time go? And you got to get through quite a bit of exam questions. And this is the best way to do it, because you know what? It'll give you at least a shot. And sometimes the less thinking we do, the better we actually do.
Absolutely.
That is one of the main problems with these exams, is people think way too much. They put way too much thought into it. Way too much. Usually if I jump on a study session with somebody, usually my response is always, quit thinking, click it, quit thinking, stop reading. Oh my goodness, stop reading, click it, quit reading. And if you've been on a study session with me, that's exactly how it goes.
That is legit.
Why are we taking so long? It's B. Gosh, look at it. It's different. Quick. Anyways, my name is Andy. I'm the guy that says that, but you're not here for what I say. You're here for Brandy. She's got her Series 6, 63, 26, 65, and her Series 7, which makes her more than qualified to teach you all the things you need to know, so that way you too can get a pass notice. And tonight, we are going to have a good night. It's going to be a lot of fun, so I'm glad you're here. But if you want to be more, you want more, you got to have more, we got more. You can join our members area, member sessions. Guys, we got live sessions. We got content. We got all kinds of stuff. We got a 21-day plan. We got some academy going on. Check it all out. We got a QR code. Just scan the QR code on the screen. If you're joining us on YouTube, there is a QR code there as well. And also hit and subscribe and hit those notifications for us, guys. Let's get some of that YouTube money. You know what I mean? Anyways. We got Instagram, we got Telegram, you can reach me at. We have all that stuff. We have study guides available, SIE 6, 63, and there's a 26. Guys, if you want to know what will help you get through the exam, get them study guides. It's easy, it's helpful. And guess what? You don't have to be a member to do it. It'll help you out and zero in on those key things, right? Mm-hmm. Kona Community, free message board, Discord. You can post questions up on there, you can get some answers. Today I even answered one. All by myself. Not really, but kind of. But anyways, this is how it goes. Brandy, is this true? And she goes, yeah, but you're going to write this.
Sort of
right. See, so I get help. So that way, if you see something on there, it's kind of coming from me, but not really.
It's Andy's spin on the accurate information.
Right. I know where to stay in my own lane. How do you work with your spouse? You stay in your own lane.
Stay in your own lane.
Mine seems to be the fast lane. I'm always going fast.
Yes.
Yeah. So why do you question it? I have Brandy's one of those wives that always hangs on for dear life when there's another car in front. And she thinks I should be on the brakes like 3 miles before.
Dude, let's not going to go there.
Fellas, you know how it is, riding around with your wife to act like they're on a wild ride from Mr. Toad's ride on Disneyland, you know?
We are.
Oh my gosh.
Because we are.
Like, no one's dead. Everybody made it. Relax. Anyways, we also have a reminder for tomorrow. We got all kinds of good stuff going on. SIE 26 and 65. Check out for those reminders. They went out earlier today. We'll have each of those going. Yeah.
Yeah.
9:30 a.m. for the SIE 26 and 65. Principals, advisors, we meet tomorrow. Anyone you want to talk about? Brandy's just saying show up. That's what she's saying.
Just be there.
She could tell you what's going on, but she'd rather just show up.
Just be there. It's important.
There you go.
No, seriously, I would be there.
Some people, I wouldn't say some people. There is a person or two that have asked, is it important for me to be there? I'm like, why would we have it if it wasn't important?
Yeah, because
I just feel like hanging out.
Yes, be there.
Just hanging out. Just figure I just pop on a Zoom, just see what's up.
Hey.
You know.
No, be there.
Nothing else I'd rather do.
Be there.
Do I have to read the study guide? I don't know. By the way, if you, look, there's some great stuff that Deion Sanders says. And one of the ones I saw today was about studying, or not studying, but practice.
Yes.
You got to get out there and practice.
Yeah.
Anybody can make a highlight reel, but it's the practice and habits that create the person that you are. So no matter what you're doing, get in there and practice. Get the practice in, get those reps in, make it happen. You
yes.
ready?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Yes. I forgot to post something on the off topic.
Oh.
I will. Good night.
All righty. All right, Test Take Your Techniques Tuesday. It is time to get those techniques and strategies and exams and quizzes and all that stuff to help you out with those, getting those questions and answers done correctly and right. Guys, sometimes it doesn't matter what we've been studying or how we've been studying or how long we've been studying. Some of those questions just don't look right. You know what I mean? It doesn't matter. Those exam questions have a lot of smoke and mirrors, and you got to be able to see through it. And it doesn't matter how you get to the right answer, as long as you got to the right answer. They're not going to ask you, let me see the work on that. This is not fifth grade, and they're not asking for your long division. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
They're not, can you run that back for me? I want to see your work. No, that doesn't happen. You got to pass, notice, walk out. That's it. I'm walking out, right? Like I say, like George Jefferson.
Yep.
Getting that strut. I'm going to convince everybody to start watching the Jeffersons. Watch. I can only hope.
Oh my goodness.
This is a great show.
It was.
Is it relevant anymore?
No,
I don't know.
Not absolutely not.
It's fun. Anyways.
It's a good show. I liked it.
I always wanted somebody like George to live next to me so I can have him walk on my back.
Solid.
Yeah. Anyways. We have rules, the Test Taking Techniques Tuesday. Rule number one, you're not allowed to ask what exam did that question come from, because it's irrelevant. It's the how we get there. It's how the patterns and all the stuff that Brandy writes on the screen, because that's how she takes her quizzes. And guess what? That's how you should take your quizzes. It'll help you keep those breadcrumbs, you know, the way to keeping anchored into the question. Guys, you got to be present in the question. It is one of the hardest things to do. Not giving too much information, not going beyond what's being asked. This is a great way to be anchored into the question,
mm-hmm.
and answering only the question.
Yes.
It's like being in court. Please answer the question.
I did. No, you answered everything but the question.
Right.
That's me.
Right. Too much information.
That's me.
Secondly, how do we get good at anything? We got to practice. We got to practice. You got to practice. Can't be Allen Iversons. You got to practice. What do we want you to do? We want you to do a 10-question, 10-minute quiz.
Mm-hmm.
We call it the flash quiz.
Yes.
That means 10 minutes of just not thinking, just going for it in your gut. And guess what? Sometimes people get actually better scores. And what does that tell you?
Think too much.
You think way too much. You need to think less. You need to relax and think less. Relax, think less, breathe. So we want you to try that, knock that out, see what you get, and see what happens.
Yeah. And guys, I have to say, tonight we were watching something on the YouTube. And I was.
Oh.
With the children. And I said, ooh, I cannot focus. I was getting questions wrong. Well, to be honest with you, I wasn't really looking at the words on the screen. I'm being honest with you guys, right? So I'm like, man, it's really hard to find.
You're going through the motion.
Yeah, I'm like, it's really hard to find questions for tonight. And I go, okay, wait, hold on. Stop. Just turn that off for a second so I can pull these questions, guys. And then it was like, bam, 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 bam. The next 6 questions, all techniques. That's literally how it went today.
Do we need to know content?
No. I said techniques, guys.
Just making sure.
Techniques.
Brandy, because I just started.
Huh. You guys ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's do it. All right. Answers first, right? For only the past year. First of all, that sounds weird, but for only the past year, over the life of the fund only, over the last 1 year and the life of the fund, averaged out as if the fund existed for 10 years. Huh? How, why, what? Like, okay. So let me talk about something right here. So we call this particular technique, we call Mona. Okay. Where we see the must, only, right? Never, or always. Okay. That's what I noticed first, right? So I circled the two onlys. Mm-hmm. Those are usually not true. Okay. Usually not true, right? Then C has the word and in it, and we like answers with the word and in
it. I do.
And to be
you can't have Andy without and.
True. And to be completely honest, didn't even read D. So I even just didn't even notice the 10.
It's like you saw it and you were just like, huh? And then you skipped it.
Because guys, look, averaged out as if the fund existed for 10 years. Why? Why? Like, why would I average something out as if?
As if is kind of weird.
That's weird. Like,
what why? Am I future telling?
Yeah. Like, why would I do that? Like,
am I Miss Cleo?
And even though you guys haven't studied, wouldn't you guys want clear, concise, true information?
Yeah. I don't want it. I don't want it to like seem like it came from Dionne Warwick and her psychic friends.
As if, right? No, we don't want that. So then I think the answer is C, based purely on two onlys, and a as if doesn't make sense. Okay.
Oh, should we look at the question though?
We should. A mutual fund has been in existence for 3 years. The prospectus must disclose the fund's performance. How about C?
This is a clear question of where you could get confused on what you're supposed to remember.
Yeah.
Does that make sense? Like you'd be like, oh, I don't know. Over the past year. Oh, I don't know. Over the life of the fund. Oh, that sounds kind of good. Guys, this is where you plug in your common sense and use those techniques. Yeah.
Somebody put it in the chat and I didn't even catch it when I went over the. So these are both starting off the same. And this one had an and, that one had the only. Boom. Right? Now, of course, I can give you content to back that up, but
not on Test Taking Techniques Tuesday.
That's right. Answer's A, because it's the only one that says 36.
That's it.
Oh, wait, hold on. Once a customer account has been opened at a broker dealer, rules require that updating the information on the account record occur no less frequently than once every 3 to 6 months.
Again, sometimes you just go with it. Just go with it.
Yeah.
Because it is A, because it's got 36 months.
Now somebody might ask me, well, we didn't go with the 10 in that one.
No, but it didn't make sense either because there was an only in there.
Plus the techniques with the only and the two similars, it just made sense to go with C.
And C looked the most right.
Yes, exactly. But that one, I'm not even going to think about that, right? Do you guys see that we answered this question in legit 2 seconds?
It's called banking time.
Exactly. And that's the thing is that, you know, sometimes we get so caught up in what if I run out of time, where you're going to see a question like this and you guys will answer it in 2 seconds.
So if you're ever worried about the time thing,
just click on 36 months. Sorry.
There you go.
My picture keeps moving. All right. IPO, repo, SPO, APO.
Well, repo is a car thing.
Plus, doesn't the word, I mean, doesn't the letters RE, isn't that again?
It is called repossession.
Yes. Right? Okay, so check this out. You guys ready?
Yep.
It would be appropriate to refer to any of the following as an issuer transaction except the again. Or the car.
Or the fact that it's a car thing and not really a transactional thing that you remember in this situation, right?
Yeah, and honestly,
there is a repo, blah, 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 repurchase agreement.
Who cares? But who cares? That's it.
I would have gone with B.
Yeah. Yep, me too. Oh, wait, I did. Ownership and control of the investments in the account. Ownership of the account only. Control of the investments in the account only. The sole individual allowed to access the account. Oh, A and B do start the same. This has only. This has so only. Sole is only.
Is only.
And A has.
And. I would go with A.
Go with A? Okay.
You should probably look at the question.
How an account is registered determines ownership and control.
That is how you get things right without looking at the question. By the way, if you're getting closer to your exam and you're like, you're scoring pretty good, and you're like, what else can I do to sharpen my tools? Start playing the game of getting it right without looking at the question.
Guys, listen to what I said when I started this off. I said when I was super distracted, I was focusing too much on what was happening. I wasn't kind of paying attention to the techniques. I wasn't looking for the ands. I wasn't looking for the onlys or the numbers. And it was really hard to do. I turned off YouTube and I literally hit the next six questions using these techniques. These were literally the next questions. Boom, 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 boom. And all I was doing was looking for the technique. It's all I did. Okay. Okay, look, check this out. I'm going to show you guys another example, right? An officer, an unaffiliated, the corporation CFO, a director. What? Check this out. Which of the following considered control persons except control, except control, except? How about the one that has no affiliation?
You're not even affiliated. You can't tell me what to do.
Now, look, yes, there could be content associated with this on the back end with the percentages, but I didn't have to even deal with that.
Why are we diving deep if we don't have to?
I'm going to try to get the answer right based on the front end of the answer first. And if I have to go to the back end of the answer, okay, so be it.
All right, I'll put sports in it because that was too complicated. If I have an easy layup and there's no one defending me, am I going to wait for the rest of the team so I can pass the ball? Or am I just going to throw it up in the basket?
Now, how he's right. Now, how would I have answered this if I was
ooh, fourth time this year.
Now, how would I have answered this if I was taking like a full quiz or on my exam? I literally would have gone pretty sure that's, oops. I would have gone pretty sure that's the answer. Check that. That's less than 10%. Yep, that's the answer. Boom. So I took two more seconds to confirm that that simple boom, 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 boom was right.
What I wouldn't advise is keep reading it over and over again until you like convince yourself that the easy layup was the wrong one. Have you ever done that where you just like you knew it was B, you should have clicked B, but you just went ahead and just kept on reading it four or five more times until you convinced yourself, well, that's not the right one. And then you go and pick it the one that was wrong, and then you go and find out that you were right the whole time and you go, Oh. Well, I should have just went with B.
Dang it.
And then you got a whole dang it.
Yep. Didn't go with my gut.
Go with the gut.
Yes. I don't know if you guys know this, but your gut knows more than your brain sometimes.
I love a basket of currencies.
I saw this one.
Excuse me. I would like a basket of currencies.
Like literally, I was like going ring around the rosy.
I would also like a bucket of beer. A bucket of beer and a basket of currency. Thank you.
Yes. What is that? I don't even know.
Can I have a trough of food?
Okay. And then I'm looking at, okay. So then I see, so like, just, we're just going to like laugh at that, right? Because that's hilarious, right? And then I have US dollars and I have the Chinese
yuan
and euros, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So then I was looking at the question. And first of all, it says American depository receipts. And it says for a French corporation. Now, in my head, don't catch me on this so much, guys. But in my head, I go, well, I don't see France listed in my answer choices. So then it must be that link. Now, yes, I know that France accepts euros.
France is part of the euro.
I understand that. I get that. But because it specifically said US dollars and Chinese yuan, I'm looking for the French. Blanc?
Huh? Franc?
Franc? I was close. I didn't have the ronk. Onk.
Franc.
Yes.
Frank.
Frank? Yeah, whatever. But you guys got it, right? So
I don't think they use the franc anymore. I think it's all euro.
I don't know. Because I know some European countries kept their currency and used.
I don't know. It's too much thought.
Way too much thought. But do you guys see that? I just went based off what was there and went, it's US dollars.
Yep, because that one was, I'm proud to be an American. I'm picking U.S. dollars, and that's it.
But you guys, look, we could have well, France.
Smoke and Mirrors was the French corporation. That's that.
Yeah. Yeah.
What does it say? Does France still use the franc? Nope. I was pretty right.
Yeah.
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 I was pretty sure on that.
Yeah. I guys, look, I am an investment advisor representative. I passed all of these licenses.
No one's asked you what the French use as their main currency?
No.
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 There you go. Don't need to know.
Exactly.
Do you know what you do know?
What?
In America, we use the US dollar.
That is very true.
Because America, it's all it needs to know. All right, everybody. Keep it simple. Keep it simple. Keep it simple. Keep it simple. Don't overthink it. Go get your quizzes on and just go with it. Be silly. Have fun with it. It doesn't have to always be so dang serious. Breathe. Like Kenya was saying after the brew yesterday, she's like, I started breathing, and guess what? I started scoring better.
Yes.
It turns out, fun fact, helpful testing and quizzing advice. You guys, write this down. It helps to breathe when you quiz and take your exams.
Yes. And guys, on the most simple, basic form, breathing keeps you grounded.
It does. It clears your head. Oxygen to your brain helps the brain function. Turns out if you hold your breath the entire time, guess what? You're probably going to get it wrong.
Yeah.
Because you're looking for breath instead of looking for answers.
It's like, I'm not focused on these words. I need some oxygen.
So relax. Have fun. Guys, we have member stuff happening tomorrow. We'll be back same bat time, same bat channel for the Studying Brew. We will be doing free content Wednesday. We hope to see you there.
Yeah.
Thank you all for being here, because you could have been anywhere else, but you are here. So have a good night, everybody. Stay safe out there. Wash your hands. Don't touch your face. Don't touch your friend's face. That's all I know. Keep that positive mental attitude. PMA, everybody. Have a great...
Guys, thank you so much for being on. We super appreciate you. Practice these techniques in your flash quizzes. We will see you guys tomorrow. Have a great one.